Hello, friends. I'm Rich Carlson, the Senior Cloud Solutions Architect here at Microsoft, and I welcome you to another episode of the Microsoft Partner Technical Success Channel. At Microsoft, we value our coveted partners and the innovative services and solutions that they bring to market. Today, we'll discuss how Microsoft partners can utilize a Microsoft Cloud for Healthcare to provide trusted and integrated cloud capabilities that deliver better experiences, better insights, and better care. And on that note, I would like to introduce you all to Puneet. Puneet is a senior cloud solutions architect on the US One Commercial Partner team specializing in healthcare industry solutions. And on that note, take it away, Puneet.
Hello, everyone. This is Puneet Jayasingh. I'm going to spend a few minutes talking about the Cloud for Healthcare. So Microsoft Cloud for Healthcare is an end-to-end industry-specific cloud solution that includes release and new capabilities, which come to life in Microsoft Azure, Microsoft 365, Dynamics 365, Power Platform, with a common data model. It's called Dataverse now. So all built on the foundation of security and compliance. And our partner ecosystem extends the value of this platform with custom-built solutions for healthcare. So all in all, Cloud for Healthcare brings together trusted and integrated capabilities that deliver automation and efficiency on high-value workflows, and as well as data analysis functionality for both structured and unstructured data that enable healthcare organizations to turn insights into actions. So it includes capabilities to manage healthcare data at scale and makes it easier for healthcare organizations to improve patient experience, coordinate care, and drive operational efficiency while helping support end-to-end security, compliance, and interoperability of healthcare data. So the why is there have been systematic issues that healthcare organizations must address, and healthcare has been in transition. So what we've been noticing that patients have high expectations towards their doctors, insurers, and for the treatments that they receive. So 81% of the patients are unsatisfied with their current healthcare experiences. So now the way the patients and consumers interact with our healthcare providers has been forced to change. While prior to the pandemic, you know, that was just a systematic issues in healthcare and everyone just dealt with them. And now the healthcare providers understand that they must meet the needs of the customers and patients and give them better customized experiences. So providers must ensure, you know, how they are engaging with their patients. Like, are they sending them text messages? Do the patients prefer to interact with bots? Or does someone need to contact the patients over the phones? So this all falls under the customized engagement model. And then the global healthcare industry loses $6.2 billion per year to data breaches. And this is putting patients at risk and straining already tight budgets. And there are growing pressures for security and compliance in healthcare. So this is a huge need, actually, which we are addressing with the Azure as the foundation of data estate, ensuring that we are up to date on security and compliance. And 41% of the providers say that the data and analytics challenges are actually preventing them from succeeding in value-based care model. So value-based care model is where the industry is moving, like, for example, proactive ways of providing care, keeping patients out of the hospitals via remote monitoring, proactive follow-up. So providers and payers are looking to solve these challenges with data and AI. And the last one is the provider burnout. So there has been, this has been all-time high, the provider burnout, since the pandemic. And it is estimated that by 2030, there will be 14 million provider shortages for healthcare workers worldwide, which is astounding. So we need to find better ways to engage with our customers, and that means efficient workflows and automation. And these challenges are the ones we are looking to solve with the Cloud for Healthcare. In our initial release is a provider-centric release, and we are focused on four key areas. And the first one is the enhancing patient engagement. And this is really enabling that rich data to flow securely through every point of care. So we can improve the experiences and give them better healthcare outcomes. And the goal here is to tear down those data silos and have a unified data across the care continuum so that the healthcare organizations can enhance overall patient experience. And the second scenario is about empowering healthcare teams to collaborate and communicate better in an environment which will lead to an improved experience for the patients. And a part of that is being able to deliver virtual health capabilities. So which has become so important since COVID, for example, virtual consults or virtual visits, as well as the capabilities for things like, you know, virtual rounding of hospitals, ability to provide transcriptions, and ability to provide information to the contact centers. So this is all about automating the ways we are contacting the patients without duplicating the efforts. And we also want to ensure that, you know, the health team collaborations here, so that everyone who is involved in that health team, every single care member, we want them to be able to collaborate to the best of their ability so that they can share the information about each patient and coordinate their care and have a secure environment that the people feel safe in. And the third one is about improving clinical and operational insights. So we know that the data is oxygen to every healthcare organization. And when you can help organization harness both clinical and operational data from internal and external resources, they can accelerate diagnosis, reduce time to treatment, and improve overall operational efficiencies of the care system. And finally, the most important one, we have to make sure to protect health information. And we know how important health information is to all healthcare organizations and their patients. So providing the health sensitive information is super important and ensuring that we are providing privacy, security, and necessary compliance to all our solutions. And we are addressing this within our Azure as the foundation of the data state. The next one, here, if we look at it, these are the 9 core capabilities which we are giving with the Providercentric, our first release. So each of these capabilities are composable, meaning that they can be deployed one at a time or in groups, and customers and patients can leverage their existing investments in Microsoft Cloud technologies by applying these capabilities to solutions that are already developed in the environment. So when we break these into 3 areas a bit further, you can actually see the specific capabilities within each of them. So for example, enhanced patient engagement, you are giving that personalized care by using real-time data to build personalized patient outreach programs that create proactive care experiences and transform data into prescriptive insights. And you have the opportunity to have virtual health with teams integrated within the systems. So the next one, you know, empowering health team collaboration by optimizing resources and solve problems collectively and coordinate through intelligent workflows. And then you have continuous patient monitoring with your IoT and analytics to optimize treatment. And then with your clinical and operational insights, we have the analytics for both clinical side and operational side. And you have that data interoperability that brings all of it together so that you can gain insights on top of everything. The first, you have the existing structured and unstructured data, consumer generated data, claims data, clinical data, IOMT, EHR, social determinants, medical imaging, and data in the healthcare provider or peer setting. So all these are scattered in 15 to 20 different solutions. So then we are using Azure as the baseline for interoperability, Azure API for FHIR to provide the ability to pull all the data together. So Azure API for FHIR makes it easier for anyone working in the healthcare data to ingest, manage, and persist PHI in the cloud. And in Azure, you can also take advantage of artificial intelligence and machine learning. And you know, security and compliance are inherent to the Azure platform. So you can bring in the transactional data into Dataverse or the common data model. So you will have everything combined in one space, and you can build your apps on top of that, and where that's using, you know, Power Platform, Office 365, Teams, Dynamics 365, or Advanced Analytics, and that data can then interact between all those places. So ultimately breaking down the silos and creating an integration between the clouds is what Microsoft Cloud for Healthcare is providing. So we are building three clouds or cross-cloud solutions, and then tailoring experiences that are specific to the healthcare industry. So then on top of that, you can see the SKU for the Cloud for Healthcare. So what does that have? So what is the SKU all about? So here, the SKU has unique capabilities specifically designed to meet the healthcare's most pressing needs. So this is an end-to-end, highly configurable platform, and you can take advantage of the healthcare-specific capabilities, including healthcare bots, portals for patient and care teams, templates, apps, AI models and intelligence, custom-built Power BI dashboards, pre-built configured workflows, and much, much more. So by bringing all this together within the Cloud for Healthcare, healthcare organizations then can enhance, you know, patient engagement, empower health team collaboration, and improve clinical and operational insights while protecting the healthcare information. So your clinicians, care members will be using the same data model as your call center agents and home health nurses through Dataverse, which is ultimately pulled from the foundational piece of Microsoft Azure and Azure API for Fire. So when we look at the Cloud for Healthcare, we have improved outcomes across the entire care continuum, where you can see all the capabilities I've just mentioned built on top of that core foundation. So all in all, this is what we give you when we give you Microsoft Cloud for Healthcare. And as I mentioned with the initial release, this is focused on the provider side with some capabilities on the payer vertical. And our roadmap will deliver capabilities across all the verticals, including biopharma and medtech. Let's switch gears now and talk about partner side of this and what we see the partner opportunity. Our healthcare partner ecosystem does this in five key ways. The number one being the build, by building new or updating existing SaaS or other applications for specific healthcare systems, or at scale using Microsoft Cloud for Healthcare as a platform. The second one is extending. This is by embedding healthcare cloud capabilities and features such as Microsoft's healthcare bot or Azure API for Fire within the partner's applications or platforms. And then enriching, you know, by building healthcare vertical specific applications for healthcare providers or payers or pharma or medtech on Microsoft Dynamics, Office, Microsoft 365, Power Platform, and Microsoft Azure. And then connect is using APIs, connectors, and extensions to connect and drive interoperability between Microsoft Cloud for Healthcare and the partner developed solution. And then the last one is enabling, you know, to drive functional implementation of the Microsoft Cloud for Healthcare, including customization aligned to each customer's need and business processes, or cloud interoperability across each customer's systems, and providing services for data governance and adoption. So we're going to continue to expand and support our ecosystem of healthcare partners who can provide solutions that complement and extend Microsoft's Cloud for Healthcare core capabilities. So using these partner expertise will help healthcare organizations through EHR and platform integrations, implementation services, and healthcare SaaS offerings. Hope this was helpful. Thank you.
Thank you, Puneet, very much for the insightful introduction into Microsoft Cloud for Healthcare and all of its powerful capabilities. And I also thank you all for viewing this informative video. Look for more informative episodes to come on the Microsoft Partner Technical Success Channel. Thank you.
Thank you, Richard.